表して
残さず耐え投げろ、
打ち抜く色速ゼックス。
Just like that, we're back. What's up, everybody? This is Cage Christian here. Welcome you guys back to another episode of Shinobi Versus. To Senran Kagura, Shinobi Versus. This is Cage Christian here, playing as... Wait for the doors to open to show you my other waifu! Open the Opai Ninja. Not into a sad music. My family is huge. I'm the oldest of 12 brothers and sisters. Mom just didn't know when to take a break. Two of the younger ones are twins, and three more of them are triplets. Mom had 12 kids in 9 years. She was amazing. There she is, Yozakura. Hey guys, keep it down, will ya? Every day in my house was like a festival. The babies were crying night and day, and the older ones, just out of diapers, ran around playing out, scrambling for snacks. We had two quadruple bunk beds. Oh, in our room. Okay. I was like, wait, what? I thought they were like children, a set of children. They didn't start out that way, but when each baby turned 1 year old, my parents added another bunk on top of the rest. At that time, we had finally gone up to 10. It was like sleeping in a submarine. Every day ended with dinner time. As soon as everybody smelled what was cooking, they'd all get together in the kitchen.
Aww,
look at the little guys. Didn't matter if they were fighting or taking a nap, they'd stop what they were doing and help me carry the food out and set the table. Of course, they weren't helping just to be nice. They were trying to scope out the menu and find out the best place to sit. It's a daily struggle in my family that size. Or in a family that size. And they figured out that helping me was the best way to win.
Aww.
That was a battle cry for the dinner war. Whoever got the best position would eat their favorite food and not say anything. Everyone else would push and complain and cry. She got more rice than me. Ew, I hate carrots. He stole my beef. I didn't want tea. I wanted orange juice. You know how it goes. Me, I tried to keep everybody happy, so I walked the main dish around for everybody and brought orange juice for the kids who didn't drink tea. Of course, well, they kept me busy with that. They ate all the food. Aww. Would have been nice to sit down and eat with them like a regular kid, but that's not how it was. Because our mom died on a mission right after she had her 12th kid.
Aww.
Guess she was rusty being away from the shinobi life for all those years raising us. And this is terrifyingly sad. So I had to be everybody's mom from then on. At least I decided I had to be. I looked after all of them and smiled for them all the time no matter how I felt. Dad was too busy with his shinobi work to come home, so who else was going to look after the little ones but me? Now taking care of 11 selfish, pushy little kids turned out to be a little tougher than I thought. But I did my best every day. I taught them what I knew, settled their fights, patted them on the head, then when they got good grades, scolded them when I had to, and laughed at when the situation called for it. Yeah, it was hard, but I had no complaints. I kind of liked it, actually. All that energy all around me kept me going. Until a little less than a year after Mom died is when Dad died too. Same as Mom, in the line of duty. At Dad's funeral, I heard all my relatives whisper around the coffin. That's not fair. I jumped right into the middle of them. Yeah, picture hearing that from a 9-year-old. Didn't matter how serious I was, nobody believed me. I don't blame them. So all my little brothers and sisters went off with different relatives. I was supposed to go too, but I didn't. First chance I got, I ducked out and ran away. I could live alone. I had to prove it. If I shoved that to my relatives, they definitely let me take the kids. I know, spoken like a 9-year-old child. I had no plan, no real experience, and just a little bit of pocket change. I blew through it in a day. That night, I found a park to sleep in. Come with me. Master Kurakage. That's right, man. Master Kurakage. My voice was almost gone. I was so hungry and tired. Master Kurakage held out his hand, the roughest hand I'd ever seen. I wanted to make a joke about me and Yuzakura having more than 12 kids, but right now, learning about her situation is so freaking sad. Losing her parents in the line of drama. Line of duty of being a great shinobi. He took my hand and held it tightly. Rough as it was, his hand was strong and warm, and that's the way he raised me. Like, it's so sad. Take care of her entire little siblings, and then she loses them when she loses her father as well. Tough life. Are you Katsuragi? This is my secondary, like, you know, Opai Ninja in command. Or she should be my leader. Back off of me, you pervert! Spoken like a true Opai Ninja. This is very true. Alrighty, let's hear him. Behind closed doors with your significant other. Wait, what? And out on a mission with an unsuspecting guard. What? Wait, what? No, all that time, it cheapens the whole thing. Very true. I like that. Suspected guard. Just shameless. Wow. Okay. Alright, let's beat her ass. Let's punch her teeth in, how about it? She resorts to kicking. Let's go. Sink into the endless dream. Oh, look at this power! Wait, yeah, I played as Yuzakura as well. Pretty sure I have. Oh, like, I'm pretty sure she should be level 1. Yeah, she's got... Oh no, she's got 3 scrolls. Maybe not. What the hell? I thought I played with her. Ready, Hikama! Bap, bap, bap! I will punch the world! Bah! Take him out. Her attack to the charge is well. Bam! Boom! A little shotgun blast. Drah! Come, you lesser shinobis! You're no stronger than your elite. Your elite Hanzo is just a joke. They're very fragile. Oh! I'm gonna fight in this classroom. Alright, what should I aim for? Actually, it's Cat. I'm gonna aim for the Opas. Hers are huge. Cat. Oh, Cat. Release your shirt to me, my dear. Oh my lord, I'm just destroying Cat. I might not even give it a chance! Be gone! I'm sorry, Opai Ninjas, but I will send her to paradise hell! What? She survived? Okay, okay. I'll give you that. I'll give you that, Cat. But I'm still gonna strip you down. It's not gonna stop that. Now it just gives me more of a chance to rip off those beautiful, protective nipple guards. Oh god! Don't hit me. Don't you taunt me either, you beautiful woman. There she goes. You've released it. Opai Ninja's powers activate. Say goodbye to the asset ninja. Here comes the Opai Master. Be gone. Both hands, I rip thy blouse. Your bra is mine. Release them to me. Oh, yes! All nude Hanzo so far. Yes! With these hands, I gripped each breast. Good job, Yosakura. Hi. Oh man, that was good. I'm surprised she survived that. Did you guys see how much health she had? I hit her with my secondary. Oh, mommy, so soft and warm. Naturally.
あんた強いな。久しぶりに楽しめたよ。戦いを楽しむ？どこまであなたは快楽至上主義なのですか？快楽至上主義？不愉快じゃ不潔じゃ。そうは言われてもな。これがあたいの性分だし。あ、あなたの少年を叩き直すのは簡単ではなさそうです。 もっと長期的な指導が必要ですね。長期的？ですので、今日はここまでにしておきます。次に会う時はもっと厳しく指導します。それまで、せいぜい精神修行をしておいてください。She's
just like a mama. So responsible, I love it. Supreme pleasure. I knew I'd get it, eh? Good job, Yosakura. Oh, and guys, I just thought about it. I realized when to start the video. I'll start it when the cutscene's going, you know what I mean? So you don't see the save override stuff. I mean, I'll still end it there, but I'm gonna, you know, continue. Yeah. You guys know. You guys are ninjas. You guys keep up with me. You're quick. So I'll save it, like, right here. Alrighty, guys. So I thank you guys for watching, everybody. This is KH Christian. Hopefully you guys enjoyed Yosakura's tragic story and you guys got to learn a little bit more about her. It was very sad. I shed a ninja tear. And remember, ninjas, it's okay to cry. This is KH Christian. Kimito!